Chapter 7, trading systems, impulse system, a censorship system. You need self-control in the markets more than anywhere else. It's important if we don't do things ourselves to impose a structure on ourselves which will tell us what is okay and what is not okay to do. And for me, that structure is the impulse system, is the censorship system. I'm sure you've noticed that some bars are green, some bars are blue, and some bars are red. What does it mean? What does it mean that the impulse system is green? Well, there are three colors, and these colors are based on two parameters: the fast moving average and the slope of a MACD histogram. So what is the fast moving average doing here? It's rising, right? What is the MACD histogram doing here? It's rising. And that's why the bar is green. If we go, let's say, to Amazon, what's the slope of the fast moving average? It's down. What's the slope of a MACD histogram? It's down, so the bar is red. Every move can be described in terms of inertia and power. Inertia is the slope of the moving average. Power is the slope of a MACD histogram. If both are rising, the bar is green. If both are declining, the bar is red. If they go opposite each other, the bar is blue, neutral. The impulse system catches every trend. There is no such thing as a trend not caught by the system. But you get killed in the transitional zones. Red, blue, green, red, blue, green, red. The impulse system kills you in transitional zones. This is not a trading system. It's a censorship system. It doesn't tell me what to do. It tells me what not to do. So if both the EMA and the MACD are rising, the impulse is green, I'm prohibited from shorting. If both EMA and the MACD are falling, the impulse is red, I am not allowed to buy. If I want to buy DDD, high-flying stock that fell from $100 to almost $30 a share, I look at the weekly chart, and the weekly chart is very nice and bottomy. I'm allowed to buy. I look at the daily chart, and the daily is red. And I'm looking at it every morning. And the chart says, Alex, sit on your hands. And so I never bought it last week. Now I have to decide whether I want to buy it next week, perhaps. But you see what I mean? So the impulse system is the censorship system which tracks two parameters of the market, the slope of the moving average and the slope of a MACD histogram. What you can see here very quickly is an entry into a trade, the weekly chart. This stock happens to be Eli Lilly. It's climbing, 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 green, 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 and here at the right edge it's blue. Blue means you're no longer prohibited from selling it short, right? The green is gone. The signal is not given by color. The signal is given by the disappearance of color. It stopped being green. We go to the daily chart, and you can see how the daily goes from green to blue, and now it's in full swing down to red. A bearish divergence on the daily chart really sends the stock spinning. I'm always thinking, which to discuss first, the triple screen or the impulse system? So today I did the impulse system, the censorship. But let me actually come now to the system that I trade, and that's the triple screen trading system. The decision to trade needs to be atomized, not itemized as somebody transcribed it, but atomized, like molecules go down into atoms. You shouldn't say, oh, it looks kind of good, or it looks kind of bad. You should say, what are the parameters that you're going to trade now? We'll get to the exact planning later. But one thing which has to be atomized is this, strategic and tactical decision. Strategic decision, I am a bull, or I am a bear, or I don't know what this thing is doing, I'm moving on to the next one. And then a tactical decision, how do I implement what the weekly chart told me? Here is the sequence. You choose your favorite time frame, and you're not allowed to look at the chart. So if your favorite chart is daily, you're not allowed to look at it. You go to the chart one order of magnitude longer, to the weekly chart. And then on the weekly chart, you make a decision. Are you a bull or are you a bear? You know, so many people, they just go closer, closer, closer to the screen. And now you can get live data free, right? So let's see what the 5-minute chart is doing. Instead of going into the screen, push away from it. Take a bird's eye view, the weekly chart. Are you a bull? Are you a bear? Then you go down to the daily chart, and that's where you look for your entry and exit points. Entry point, target, and stop. Here it's all spelled out line by line. And so here are the rules. Strategic decision on the long-term chart. Tactical decision on your own time frame. So if you like the daily chart, you don't look at it until you review the weekly first. And so once you made a trading decision, check that trading decision against the weekly chart. Does the impulse system allow you to trade, or is it too early? So triple screen trading system, S&P. Well, first, what I always like to do with every chart, I want to compress that chart and take a look at a very long-term history, multi-year history. And by the way, we spoke about divergences. This was the divergence at the top of the 2007 bull market. Prices went to a new high, a little dark. MACD lines gave a major divergence. MACD histogram made a slight divergence. Another major divergence occurred here. Another major divergence occurred here in this area. So you can see how the S&P collapsed to a new low in 2009. This was the bottom of 2008. Depths of MACD histogram, pulled back to value, and a second break. Look at this fantastic bullish divergence. I mean, it just jumps at you from the screen and grabs you by the face. And that was the beginning of this great bull market. Well, this bull market has now been going for 5 years, much longer than average. And here we are at the right edge of the screen. What do we see? Prices are above the upper channel line. The impulse system is green. And I hope you can see it, but if you cannot see it, no big deal, because you look at the moving average, rising. You look at MACD histogram, rising. So everything is in gear to the upside. Mr. Bull is in charge. I am bearish with steam coming out of my ears, but this chart says you're not allowed to sell short. I look at force index, and I see how it cannot pull up to the upper channel line. It's weak. Bearish, bearish, bearish. And what does the green impulse system says to me? Not allowed to sell short. But I'm allowed to look, right? I'm allowed to plan. So we go to the daily chart. And what do we see here? Well, I want to show you, there was a fantastic pattern here, which I am happy to say I traded. My friend Kerry and I were running a live class that day. And speak about timing. This was September, next Monday. So this is how the market closed on Friday, that previous time. We have an upside breakout, potentially a false breakout. We have a peak A of MACD histogram. We have break B, the back of Mr. Bull gets broken. And at the right edge of the screen, MACD histogram is rising, right? And the color of the impulse system is green, not allowed to sell short. That was Friday. What a difference a day makes. Monday, it opens lower. The color early in the day changes to blue. By the end of the day, it was red. And MACD histogram ticks down. So this was peak A of a divergence, and this was peak C of a divergence, ABC. Power of bulls, breaking the back of the bulls, and here Mr. Bull came back. And that's what he delivered us, that's all. And I sold short, right there in front of the group, put out over $250,000 worth of shorts. And they just opened up and went down and down and down. In any case, so that was history. Always nice to look at the past. Let's take a look at the present. This tremendous rally goes on, and we have the power of bulls. Peak A. There is a break, and this break breaks the back of the bull. B, sort of ABC pattern. And now, this was Friday. On Friday, the impulse system closed green. Rising MACD histogram, rising fast moving average. And to me, this thing is just, it's standing on very thin ice. Bearish as bearish can be. Not allowed to sell short, right? Not allowed to sell short. Fortunately, have an indicator that will tell me at what level I am allowed to sell short. Now, remember, the color of the impulse system depends on the slope of MACD histogram and the moving average. So if I can figure out at what number MACD histogram will tick down, that will be the level at which point handcuffs are off. So S&Ps went out on Friday at 2075. And this dot tells me that if the S&Ps trade below 2076 and a half, the color will change to blue. So basically, if the S&Ps do not improve their Friday's performance by a point and a half, handcuffs are off in the daily chart. Let's take a look at the weekly. On the weekly, handcuffs will be off at 2080 and a half. So basically, as long as the S&Ps do not trade above 2076 and a half, I'll be legal to sell short. Does it work every time 100%? No. Does it work majority of times? Yes. And that's how I will be trading this coming Monday. Let me say a few words about ETFs. I hate them. Now, there are some ETFs which are okay. Spider is okay. Big, huge ETFs. So this is small caps ETF. What do I see on this chart? Before you say, I am bullish, I am bearish, describe what you see. When you keep a diary of your trades, which I urge you to do, put out a chart and write on the chart, or just mark it with circles or with arrows. What do you see there? Describe before you start concluding. So the first thing that jumps in my eye on this chart is that force index gave us a sell signal here. Right? You see how during this wonderful run up, force index went outside of the envelope and it now sank back in. So we have a sell signal from force index. It's not a precision timing signal, but it's a useful signal. We see that prices have basically hit a high on October 31st. That's the weekly chart. And ever since then, they basically stayed flat. This was the peak. This is the peak at pretty much the same height. So we have prices are above value, approximately halfway to the manic zone. We have a sell signal from force index. And I'm bearish on the market. So I would say this is not like, I mean, this chart doesn't jump at me and grab me like that, but balancing, it looks toppy. It looks toppy. The impulse system at the right edge is green. MACD histogram is rising, EMA is rising. And the indicator says that it will turn blue below 117.85. 117.85. It went out at 117.60. So basically, if it doesn't go up from Friday, it will take handcuffs off of us. So the weekly says basically, if it stays flat, you can trade it. We go to the daily chart. The daily looks much more interesting, much more interesting. And by the way, I used to tie myself in knots looking for situations where the weekly and the daily looked great. And I finally said, don't overdo it. You're using two time frames. One has to look great, and another has to be okay. Has to be all right. Tremendous, it just improved my life a lot after I said that. And it doesn't matter whether it's the weekly or the daily. So the weekly was okay. The daily is a whole other matter. We see this tremendous upsurge giving us peak A. We see a breakout, actually repeated breakouts. And they once, twice, and now as of Friday, a third breakout going on. But those breakouts don't have a very good history. We see breaking the back of the bull. And we see the quality of rallies after that. And there's a rally at the right edge of the screen. There is a type of a divergence. I didn't want to get into it today, but I'll have to. It's called missing right shoulder divergence. This is left shoulder, break. This is right shoulder. And it looks like another shoulder will come where it will not even reach zero. So this thing looks very top heavy to me. At what level will the colors change? Below 117.06. It will stop being green. So it closed out at 117.69. It has to go down basically 63 cents to start being green. If you ask me this type of question years ago, 10 years ago, I would have stopped where I stop now, and I would have considered my job done, accomplished. I analyzed a market in multiple time frames, and I gave you levels at which the stock can be traded. Mm-hmm. There is a whole other huge, and that's what a mid-level trader does. That's where the beginner doesn't know this stuff. The mid-level trader knows this stuff and stops after he's done it. But there is a third layer, third level, and that's where real serious traders live, and that's risk management. So the system says we will be legal to trade below 117.06. So let's say at 117.05, we're going to sell this puppy short. Every trade requires three numbers: entry, target, and stop. And if you don't have those numbers, it's not a trade, it's a gamble. So what's our target for this trade? I like going back to the weekly to set up a target. And as I look at the past, I see that every once in a while this market panics, goes down to its value zone. The slow yellow line on the weekly chart is at 114.14. So I would say my target would be at least 114 for the stock. Prices swing above and below value. Well, on the weekly chart, they're above value. And I think it's reasonable to suggest that they may swing back to value. So we're shorting at 117.05. We're with a target at approximately 114, right? So we're looking to make about $3.05. Real men don't use stops, which is why I want to trade like a woman. So for a stop, we go back to the daily chart. What would be the logical stop? Well, I can tell you what an illogical stop would be. If you go to the highest high, which is 118.78, I'll bet you dollars to donuts that there is a crowd of stops at 1.1879, 1 cent above the high. Let's not do it. Let's not go with the crowd. I would say maybe the high of Friday would make sense. I'm assuming that we get a signal on Monday. If not, we'll have to rethink our stop strategy. The high on Friday was 1.1798. Well, if I was putting a stop, I would not put it at 1.1789 because people, myself included, are generally lazy. And if the high is 1.1798, I'll bet you there'll be stops at 1.18. Right? So I want to put my stop a little bit further than that. So maybe 1.1805. This way we risk exactly a dollar. So we're risking a dollar, trying to make $3. That's not a bad ratio. It's not like, you know, take my breath away ratio, which occasionally you get, but it's a workmanlike ratio. The plan for Monday, just for one day ahead, shorting at 1.1705, protecting at 1.1805, with a target at approximately 1.14. We establish the numbers. The next question is, how many shares we're going to buy? That is the question we're going to have to answer. How many shares do I buy? And please don't tell me, oh, I made money on my last trade, so I'm going to trade double, or, oh, I lost money on my last trade, so I'm going to trade nothing. I'm just going to watch it. Because that's not the way to do it. You have to trade signals and not your latest trade. Okay? I think this was as good an illustration of triple screen trading system that I could deliver to you. We analyzed this one ticker that you brought up and created a plan for Monday. So first of all, it has to go a little down in order for us. Right? If it continues to go up, your idea to sell it short stays in effect. But the plan we created will have to be redone, because those crossover points will change after one day. And then, of course, we have to look at the pattern. We'll have to look at the pattern of Monday to see where our stops will go, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. But this is an example, triple screen while controlled in the background by the impulse system.